Today we have a simple dataset, sales and dates. The dates are already sorted in ascending order, and there are only 100 records. Let's calculate a run in total step by step in Power Query. By the end, I'll show you how to optimize it for larger datasets. First, we'll create an index column starting at 1. Why? Because the index helps us define which rows we want to include in the calculation for each run in total. To do this, go to Add Column, Index Column and choose Start from 1. Next, we'll add a new column for the run in total. We'll use the Table Add Column function, which requires 3 inputs: the name of the previous step, the name of the new column, which we'll call run in total, and the formula to calculate it. In the formula, we'll use List.FirstN to get all rows from the first row up to the current one, and then List.Sum to calculate the total of those values. This gives us a run in total for each row. It's straightforward and works well with small datasets. However, if your dataset grows, this method starts to slow down. For example, with 100,000 rows, Power Query has to calculate the list for every row individually, which takes time. To make it more efficient, we'll use buffering. Imagine you have a stack of books beside you, ready to pick up whenever you need them. Buffering stores your data in memory, like a stack, so you can access it quickly without having to search for it each time. Here is how. After creating the index column, add a new stack. Type the name of the column you want to use in square brackets, sales. Wrap it in List.Buffer function to store the data in memory. And rename the step for clarity, such as buffer. Now let's go to the final step and update it. The first argument should be added index step, and at the end we will use just buffer. The result is the same. Instead of recalculating the first n rows every time, it will just pull from memory. Same result, but much faster. Let's compare. I'll switch to a 100,000 row dataset and test both methods. Watch this, without buffering and with buffering. Do I need to say more? If you are working with large datasets, buffering is your best friend. Want to learn even faster techniques for running totals? Hit the like button and let me know in the comments. Thank you for watching, I'll see you in the next video.